Hi, and welcome back to Type 1 Diabetes Explained. Today we will take a look at what counting carbs means and how to properly dose with insulin based on the amount of carbohydrates in food. If you have type 1 diabetes, before you eat, you have to give insulin so your body can use the energy in the food. But how do you know how much insulin to give? Surely a small apple doesn't need the same amount of insulin as a large slice of cake. To determine how much insulin you need to dose with, you need to know how many grams of carbohydrates are in the food that you are eating. The easiest way to find this is the nutrition label on the back of most foods. We will go over how to find the amount of carbohydrates in food without nutrition labels later on. There are several things that you need to look out for on a nutrition label to determine how many grams of carbohydrates are in the food. First, you should look at the serving size. Is it the same amount as you were planning to eat? One of the easiest ways to make a mistake when counting carbs is not realizing the serving size. Some foods that look like they should have only one serving may have two or more, which could easily double or triple the amount of carbohydrates in what you eat. So now that you know what the serving size is, the next thing that you should look at is the total carbohydrates. So now you know how many total carbohydrates are in the food, it seems like you should be done, but there are a few more numbers to take into consideration. Look and check if there is any fiber. Fiber is a type of carbohydrate that your body can't absorb, so it doesn't affect your blood sugars. Subtract the grams of fiber from the grams of total carbohydrates. Also, look for sugar alcohols. These are also hard for your body to digest, but not quite as hard to digest as fiber. Subtract 1/2 of the grams of sugar alcohols from the total carbohydrates. So let's try it. Remember the carb counting process. There are 37 grams of total carbohydrates, minus 4 grams of fiber, minus 10 divided by 2, or 5 grams of sugar alcohols, comes to 28 grams. The number after you have subtracted the fiber and 1/2 of the sugar alcohols is called the net carbohydrate. This is the number that you use when dosing for insulin. Now that we know how to find the net carbohydrates by looking at the nutrition labels, let's do a few practice counts. Look at the nutrition label and calculate how many carbs are in the food. We'll show the answer after about 10 seconds, but feel free to pause the video to have more time to do your calculations. So counting carbohydrates is pretty easy, right? But how do you find out the carbohydrates in food that don't have nutrition labels, like produce or homemade recipes? The internet has many resources that can help you count carbs in food that don't come in nutrition labels. Here are some useful resources for calculating carbs in food without nutrition labels. So now that you know how to find the net carbohydrates in food, you're ready to dose with insulin. But how much? You know how many carbs are in the food, but how do you translate that into units of insulin? It's pretty simple. Your doctor probably gave you something called carb or insulin ratio. This is a ratio that tells you how many units of insulin to give for a certain number of carbs. An example of a carb ratio could be 1 unit of insulin for every 10 carbohydrates, or 1 unit for every 7 carbs. The ratio that you use will most likely vary based on your weight, amount of physical activity, and how long you have had diabetes. So now that we know how to count carbs and then convert that number into units of insulin, here are a few more practice problems to help you master the skill. Counting carbohydrates can be a little tricky with all the different numbers to remember, and you'll probably make mistakes, but it'll get easier the more and more you do it, and soon you'll be a carbohydrate counting expert.